to episode 92 of Anime and Us. I'm TJ.
And I'm Sean.
And this is the review show that reviews anime from A to Z. Sort of.
So last episode, we spun for Category A, and we got Amagi Brilliant Park, which, as we were watching the first couple episodes together, we saw a character in it that was in Full Metal Panic.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, 10 seconds of Googling later, we found out that it's the same author.
Mm-hmm.
Or same manga writer or whatever.
Right.
And it's the stuffed animal mascot character that Sosuke plays as, dresses up as sometimes. Mm-hmm. And in the second season, he did a lot because that was the comedy part
of the
show.
Yeah, the bear with
Fumofu.
Yeah.
I can't remember his name.
I don't know.
The character has a name that he gave him, but I don't remember what
it was. I'm going to preface this right now. I don't remember any of the names of this one.
Yeah, I don't think I remember any of them either. Anyway, it's a light novel series written, it's an anime, but it was at first a light novel series written by Shoji Gatto, 8 different volumes in 2013. I wanted to say, though, that there are 3 different manga adaptations. Why 3 different ones? I don't understand. Maybe where I'm confusing what an adaptation is, but like an adaptation for me is, let's say I write a book, and then someone makes it into a movie, that's an adaptation. So why would you make 3 different adaptations of the book into a movie? That doesn't make any sense to me.
Wait, there's 3 different anime?
3 manga adaptations published by Fuji Shobo and Kadokawa. So I don't understand why there's 3 different ones. It doesn't make any sense to me.
Well, an adaptation can be just a reimagining of the same story over and over again.
Sure. That's what I'm saying. I don't understand why. It's not like it's particularly good.
No, it's not very good at all, actually.
The anime came out in 2014. So yeah. That's it for the little wiki part. This ain't good. Don't watch it. It's not. I guess it's not.
It's meh.
Yeah, it's not like ice picking my earlobe bad, but it's not good in any way.
But it's weird on a lot of levels too. If you're into strange things, it's very strange.
Yeah, it's. I said this before in a different one. What someone probably thinks anime is that doesn't watch anime, and this is probably another one of those. It's very random, crazy things happening, magic,
yeah.
This that. None of it really makes any sense. There's no real cohesive story besides the one main plot line.
I like how recently we've started with like a sum up of the show, like we're finishing it in the first 5 minutes.
So I want this one to be quick. It's this one sucks.
Anyway,
I'm not happy about it.
Premise:
there is a theme park, amusement park. I think it's an amusement park, right? More of an amusement
theme
park.
Theme and amusement park both work,
I guess. And this guy, I forget his name, his classmate, I believe they're in the same school.
Main character and love interest.
Yeah, so they're in the same class though, right?
Yes.
That's how they know.
Well, same grade.
Whatever. She works at this park and kind of forces him to go. Somehow, I forget how she forced him to go. Very minor detail in the very beginning of the show. And he goes there and he meets all these people. He meets this princess-type character.
Yeah, the amusement park is shit.
Yeah, it's terrible.
And that's why she brought him.
Run down, none of the people that work there care about it.
So apparently the amusement parks, all amusement parks apparently, are conduits for for this energy. I don't remember what they called
some,
it.
Some sort of other world that has energy in it.
They're conduits, apparently good emotions and fun as energy, so that fairies and stuff can live. And fairies are
dragons.
Dragons and stuff like that. And they're pretty much the mascots of the theme park, but they wear this necklace over them so that you can't tell that they're fairies. But they never showed them in fairy form, so they all just look like humans and fairies, except for...
Or in mascot form.
Right. You brought up the girl that brought him there. I just realized, I don't know why she's there.
She might have just got hired one day.
But they never explain why she's there, because she's not a fairy from what I can tell.
Yeah, she might... Well, they said... In one of the episodes we watched, not everyone that works there is a fairy. Some of them are humans.
Yeah, but she pulls, like, these old rifles out of her panties every...
Yeah, I think that's just the anime part of being random and crazy that I was saying earlier.
Yeah, but...
I think it's just that aspect. It doesn't really matter.
Yeah, but none of the
There's no fixing that.
But no other humans do.
Sure, but none of the other ones matter. There's only 3 humans that matter in the show.
That's true. Anyway.
She randomly pulls out these muzzle loaders that she can shoot semi-automatic, by the way.
So anyway, they bring the main character in to save the theme park. So if the theme park gets shut down, the princess who runs the whole thing will die.
Yes, because the energy created by the customers keeps her alive.
Yeah, but only because a wizard cursed her.
That we don't find out until like the second or third to last episode, something like that.
Well, we find out a little earlier than that, but it's not explained fully into the second, the third of this episode, but...
And every year, her memories get erased, and, like, her age gets erased. So she's been 14 for the past 10 years, over 10 years.
It's been a long time. And so, yeah, she keeps resetting because of the wizard's curse. Because apparently...
The whole 14 thing doesn't need to happen, though. Like, come on. I'm tired of this. Stop with the loli. I don't need it. Well, they didn't have to do that. She could have been 20.
Yeah, it's true, but to be fair, she wasn't really a love interest.
No, but it's just still, like, she's in scantily clad...
Oh, yeah, they definitely...
Clothing. She wasn't a love interest, you're right. But that wasn't needed. You're telling me she's 14. Like, what are you doing? It's not even like she has the mind of an adult in a 14-year-old body, like in an Interview with a Vampire. You know what I mean? It's still really creepy and wrong, but at least it's an adult inside the body. But this is both child.
No, I get your point, but there is enough plot points that I didn't really see it. Like, she's cursed by a wizard. Yeah, technically, she's like 400 for all we know.
She's also just kind of there for plot.
Yeah.
She doesn't really show up unless she's doing something or moving the story along in some way.
She's there so that the main character can save the theme park. I don't know why he specifically was sought out to save the theme park.
I think he was some sort of knight for her. They started calling him Sir something after a little while.
No, he wasn't because...
I know.
He, in the backstory, he met her when he was a kid.
Yeah.
But he was just a former child star.
Oh, yeah.
So, he wasn't...
And he's a narcissist, but for, like, 2 minutes of the show.
He's a narcissist. They make a point in every episode to have him looking in the mirror and saying narcissistic thing. But it's pretty clear that they're only using the narcissism to make him into a good guy. Mm-hmm. Like, he only used the narcissism.
He's got a redemption arc.
Yeah.
But it's not written well.
And the narcissism's also just a cover, essentially, to make so that he seems like a jerk, but mm-hmm. he's not a jerk. It's all pretty cliched, honestly.
Yeah.
It's cliched in a weird, masked in the weird theme park thing, because all the show is every episode is him slowly making the theme park better.
Ever so slowly.
But
what's really funny, in my opinion, is that it's dead slow in that, like, he gets a couple more visitors. He has to get 500,000 by July 31st.
Yeah, it's like 3 months or something.
And he needs, they're at 250,000, mm-hmm. so they need an extra 250. And so it's a real slow going. Every day, they're getting a couple hundred, maybe 50 more per day or something like that. But nowhere near the goal. Until, like, episode 9. And then it's like, oh, it's busy in here.
Yeah.
And, like, they're still not going to make it until the second to last episode. But...
There wouldn't be drama otherwise.
It went from slow and shit to really struggling to get a couple extra people to just one episode, bam, they're busy. I found that really weird.
Well, I mean, it seemed like each episode they're adding new elements to it. And in that episode, they showed that they finally pulled all those elements together that they gathered.
I don't think they did it well, though, but yeah.
No,
agree. Everyone was working well together, but yeah.
Right. But, I mean, honestly, I wouldn't want to go to that theme park. It didn't look very good, even after they
fixed it. Even after they fixed it.
Yeah, no.
I mean, there's a dragon.
There's a dragon, there's a pirate walrus and stuff, but it's still very...
There's no real story arcs besides them slowly getting more customers.
Oh, and they sold their property to Walmart at the end.
Was it Walmart?
It's not what they called it, but it was Walmart.
Oh, yeah. They had two properties, the northern section, the main section, and then the southern section... And you never saw the southern section until he sold it.
Because it was in disuse, and they were like, they didn't want to sell it because they wanted to expand eventually, but they needed money, so he was like, we're selling the southern company to Walmart.
I think it was just to fill like 5 minutes of dialogue. That's all, to get that episode finished. That's all I feel like it was for.
No. It was literally because they actually showed he sold it to Walmart so that they would gain more customers long term. So it was a plot point.
Yeah,
it was part of his plan.
It was really stupid.
Well, the whole show is...
They have a stadium for some reason.
Yeah, a soccer stadium. Well,
it could have been any kind of stadium, but they made it to a soccer stadium at the very least.
Well, it was shaped like a soccer stadium.
Yeah, well, it could have been football. They're all shaped the same.
Yeah, but it's Japan, and football's not really big anywhere.
Baseball's big there.
Yeah, but...
Feels different.
Yeah, that's why I thought the fields would be different than a football. No,
either way.
Well, I don't know.
Doesn't matter. Either way, for some reason, they got a stadium at this amusement park. Why?
They explained it. I don't remember why, though.
I don't think they explained it.
They explained it, but it wasn't a very good explanation. Because under the stadium, there's a whole amusement thing where they find a dragon and stuff.
Yeah. Well, anyway, they have the stadium, and there's a soccer team that needs somewhere to play, and they're broke, and he gets him to come, essentially. But he uses his power for, like, the one and only time, I think, was then.
No, he used it a couple of times, but...
when he kissed the princess girl, the first or second episode, first episode maybe.
Right, that's when
he gained a power where he can read people's minds, but only once.
He can only it's a really shitty, useless power. But
well, I mean, you could use that if you're
strategically sure, but
they don't use it well in the show.
No, it's actually they bring it up in like the second episode, and then it doesn't get used until like the the seventh episode. It gets used once.
It gets forgotten.
Uh huh. A lot of points, plot points, get forgotten and then brought back, which isn't to the show's credit, even though you would think it would be. The show was only 12 episodes. 13. Is it 13?
Yeah, 13.
Without 13 the OVA?
And then an OVA.
Oh, it's 13, then an OVA.
Because I got to 13 a couple hours ago, and I was like, oh, no, there's an OVA.
Did you watch the OVA?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's pointless.
Yeah. Well, so was episode 13. The show ended at 12.
Yeah. Yeah, you're right. 12, I thought was, or 13, I'm sorry, I thought was actually kind of funny.
Oh,
I liked episode 13 a little.
The tape?
Yeah. I mean, it was stupid. You could do two things at once. You could read a book and listen to it at the same time. But it was the plot was probably the best in the whole show. I thought it was funny.
Well, my problem was the story's over. Why are we doing this episode?
Yeah, they both should have been OVAs.
Yeah, I mean, that one was
just to continue the story and get someone to watch it.
Yeah, that one was definitely an OVA type show, but that was an actual numbered episode. I don't understand why that was there. Maybe they got
could have been numbered wrong.
Possibly, or...
Because usually animes are 12 or 14.
True.
When they're short like that.
But maybe they got licensed for 13 and they're like, we're done with 12. Maybe we should just make another one.
Yeah, maybe.
Because,
who knows?
Because literally all the plot points are wrapped up by episode 13. And it's,
12.
Or by 12.
Yeah, 12. It's all done.
It's done. There's nothing
the
left to do.
The only thing that's not actually wrapped up is the wizard
that
casts the spell. They never fix that.
No.
He she's still under...
Yeah, he casts this as the spell because... All right, we got to go into the backstory of why she was cursed. Mm. Because in her homeland in the Fairyland, whatever that place is called, they were being terrorized by a giant dragon. And the dragon was destroying all of the Fairylands. So the king got the wizard to destroy the dragon, but the wizard wanted the princess's hand in marriage in order to do it, so he does it, and the king says, no, you're not, I'm not doing it, screw you, he tries to kill him, they say on his dying breath, he curses the princess, but the wizard's not dead.
Yeah.
And then, now he's the guy that's...
The inspector that can close him down if they don't reach the contract, and I don't know why they have a contract with anyone to begin with, of 500,000 guests per year.
He's the villain in a children's movie that's trying to shut down the orphanage. That's what he is, the wizard.
He doesn't reveal himself as the wizard until...
The very, very
until
end.
Until they make 500,000.
And until he loses, and then he shows up and he says, ha, ha, ha.
I'm the wizard. Goodbye.
And whooshes away. Yeah, it's like, that was pointless.
But at the end, so it was pointless, and they didn't wrap it up. She's still cursed. But because there were so many customers at the park, there was enough of that magic energy that she didn't reset this year.
Right.
But...
So she remembers everything, but she's still cursed. She still can't leave that theme park. She's stuck there forever.
Yeah, forever.
Uh-huh. Until, something comes along and they bulldoze it over for some reason. They're,
I hope to God there's never a sequel.
I doubt it's, 6 years old by now?
Yeah. 7.
That's a long time from now. If it's...
It's possible. I've seen it a couple times with things, but probably not.
I don't think this has enough of a fan base.
Yeah, neither do I.
Because I've never... Have you heard of it?
No.
I haven't heard of it. But then again, look, you like you said in the wiki, he's got 3 adaptations.
Manga adaptations, which is so weird. I guess he wrote the light novel, and then they made it into 3 different mangas for some reason. But only with 2 different publishers. So one of those 2 publishers made it twice. What the heck are you doing?
Maybe they reprinted it?
I don't know. Well, it says 3 different adaptations, so something's got to be different than just a reprint.
That's true, too. Because light novel is different than a manga, though, right?
Yeah, supposedly they're like small books, whereas mangas are released like in very small increments weekly, bi-weekly, even, or sometimes monthly. But light novels are like, all right, I'm going to take a year and produce a little book at a time.
Well, maybe the light novel was popular enough that he was like, okay, I'll write a whole manga around it, and that was the first adaptation. And then
maybe it wasn't very good.
And then maybe he redid it, and then they were like, oh, we got an idea here, and this other publishing company.
And then another one picked it up.
Yeah.
I don't know.
It's very possible. I don't know.
I don't know why it would be popular. It's not good in any aspect. It's not even like there's an excessive amount of the ichi, because like at least then you're appealing to a certain audience. I can understand why some people like it.
What's this ichi tag?
I don't know. But there was a little bit. I'm not going to lie. his classmate love interest is naked a couple times.
Yeah, but it's...
But not nude. You know, just typical.
I don't think this was Ichi tag, because I know when it's an Ichi.
Yeah, I don't think this was. But my point is like, it's not even that. Because if it was that, at the very least, there would be some reason for people to be watching it. And I just don't see the reason for it. No, comedy and magic.
Comedy and magic. I didn't think it was an Ichi, because I know when it's an Ichi. I am... It is so frustrating when it's Ichi. Let's talk about some of the stupid episodes, like some stupid things that happened throughout, just to give an example of what things. Like, there was one episode where they sprung a leak and a pirate ship sprung out from a different dimension, and then a pirate walrus and little otters
took over, and all the customers thought it was like a part of the show.
A part of a show, because there's a water park in the theme park, too.
And the shark dolphin thing?
Yeah, and the shark who. The shark who turns into Jaws and water.
Yeah, he's this cute little, almost like a stuffed animal shark.
He looks like a mascot outside of the water.
But the basement place was flooding, and the girl he was with was going to die because it's flooding.
Mm-hmm.
So he turns into this like actual Jaws shark.
Yeah,
like they changed his animation, and he puts her in his mouth to get her out. That was kind of funny.
It had its moments with funny.
Had one or
two. It wasn't. The worst comedy one we've ever seen.
No, some of them are blaringly bad.
Yeah,
this one just falls short by the reasons.
It looked like it tried. You can tell that the guy who wrote that Full Metal Panic did do this.
Yeah, he did great in Fumofu, which is the comedy show. But I think the reason for that is because we had a full season of getting to know characters
first
in a serious setting. And we didn't get this.
But you can see that some of it shines through in here. So there was like moments of funny, but it wasn't a consistent at all.
Mm.
So yeah, the pirates are afraid of sharks. So he ends up saving that, and then the main character forces them into indentured slavery too. So the pirates have to work for the park.
Essentially, yeah. There's another one where there's these four fairies that aren't working together real well, and they go to have tea or you know lunch or whatever with the princess. And then the princess has to go get more soy sauce, I think.
Yeah.
And on her way out, she's like, oh, yeah, that button over there, no matter what you do, don't press it, and walks out. It's so poorly written. And then one of them hops up and goes, ooh, button.
Well, I actually took that as the princess did that intentionally.
If that was the case, sure, but
they didn't show it at all. It was played like, oh, my God, this is happening. Mm-hmm. But I understood it because the way it was written and the way they blatantly did it, I thought the princess...
My chair.
I thought... it was his chair. I thought the princess blatantly did that so that they would have to work together because it seemed like that she was doing.
That definitely would have been the case if they had tried to spin that at all, but they really didn't.
I think that's what it was, but they did such a poor job of telling it that they didn't get it across. But that's because it felt like that's what the story was to me in that episode.
Well, they hit the button and it essentially locks down her little castle. And the only way to get out is you have to have four people. And they got four little fairies.
Yeah, and that's another reason why I think she did it on purpose, because the tests to get out were like karaoke and...
I think it's just stupid anime and this is what's the episode's going to be, so we're going to write it.
Yeah, but it was specifically designed for those four girls.
I don't think it was. Yeah, I think it's a shitty author is what I'm saying.
No, I got you, but he wrote it specifically for those four girls.
Yeah, obviously, but I don't think he wrote it in the sense of the princess is like really good at knowing what her people needs and, well, I'm going to fix it. If that was the case, they wouldn't need this guy.
That's true. I just felt like it came off to me that way. So maybe it's just how I interpreted it.
That's fun.
There was also the one where they were poor, so they discovered there's closed attraction under the Coliseum where they get accosted by orcs. And they're not really orcs, they're disguised. I don't know else to explain them, but I call them Diglets.
Moles.
Moles, yeah.
Yeah, something like that.
But they look like Diglett from Pokemon.
Yeah.
And that's where they find the dragon, who's not really mean. He's actually a school nerd.
Yeah, has his own little attraction where he scares people for the most part.
Uh-huh. But yes, it was just stupid things like that happening throughout, and each time he gains something from it.
Mm. A couple more customers.
Customers, more some money, some more employees. Mm. You know.
Oh, the one thing I thought was funny was they started hiring people at one point.
You're right.
And they hired a porn star. Or at least what they thought was a porn star.
Yeah, yeah.
I don't actually remember. Did they give an explanation for her?
Well,
I assumed. So they're, one sec. They're hiring her, and she goes, yeah, I've got experience as an AV. In AV.
Mm-hmm.
And the main character in the Fumofu character are like pull aside and they're like adult videos, AV. You know, she starred in porn essentially. I took it as audio video club.
That was no.
But that's what I took that as. They're just getting it wrong.
I know the explanation. I remember the episode because that was the episode where they the two really raunchy, what are they called, mascots, essentially drugged the love interest in this, and she's forced to tell the truth throughout the whole episode, and that's where she had the dream about those two, three girls, and then she came in. But what happened was she says that, and it's funny because the one mascot says, I found her, my contact found her, and it was the wrong one. It was just fat, ugly thing, this smush and proportions, wrong one. And then the love interest actually gets the list of their credentials, needed to know, you know, what their past histories were and stuff like that. And then she says, and so they get to her, and there's videos, you know, like, sucking big titties or something like that on there, and she clicks on them, and it's just cows drinking from their mother. It's animal videos.
There you go.
She narrated animal videos from nature. That's all it was.
There you go. There was a funny moment when the interview concluded, and the main character leans into the mascot, Fumofu guy, and he's like, you got it? Send me the link, essentially, is what he's saying.
And
that was hilarious.
And a Fumofu guy, what are you, a pervert?
Yeah. That was probably the only moment I actually enjoyed.
I mean, like I said, there was little small moments in this that were funny. But it's overall an average anime.
I think it's slightly worse. I never would have continued watching it. Sometimes average animes I'll continue to watch out of boredom, maybe. I don't have anything better to do, but I would not continue to watch this if I had nothing
else
to do.
But it wasn't a hard watch.
It wasn't a hard watch, but it wasn't easy.
It's true. I mean, I guess.
Didn't hold my interest.
Well, no, it was not that good.
It's a 4 for me, personally.
I was going 5, but you talked me down to a 4. You're right.
What else do we got for A?
Okay, so A was Attack on Titan. It was Eizu Manga Dio.
Ugh.
You say that, but we were not hard on that.
Ugh, bad memories.
And Excel World.
Oh yeah, right, because we f***ed up last time. Attack on Titan's first for
you. Attack on Titans is just a better show all around.
Yeah, I mean, it's got issues, no doubt.
Yeah,
it's got the exposition at certain points, but it's good.
Compared to those other three, it's not even in these leagues. I still think Ace Omega Dio is better than Excel World. But we had this argument last week.
Yeah, I'm going with Attack on Titan, Excel World, Eizu Manga Dio, and then this. And this is, like, for me, it's not the last, but doesn't necessarily mean it's terrible. It's just not great.
Right.
So, good enough, sorry, for me to rank it higher.
The only difference between me and you is I switch Eizu Manga Dio and Excel World. But, you know, the funny thing is, I think we gave Eizu Manga Dio, Excel World, and this around the same score.
Well, you know, a lot of times we also grade things for what it is and not against other things. Like, you can't grade Fooly Cooly and Full Metal Panic the same. They're different.
And at the same time, back when we were reviewing it, when we did Excel World, it was like our third or fourth episode, so we didn't have this ranking thing down or score thing down yet. So maybe it would be a different score if we had watched it now, but can't tell for sure.
All right. You ready?
Yeah, you can spin for B and see what crap we get.
Let's see what we get. There's a lot in B. A lot of bad. A couple things that looked interesting. I thought we're getting an Big O past it, though. Black Butler? I think that's what that is. We'll see in a second. Black Bullet, not Black Butler.
Yeah, that's interesting.
I don't know what Black Bullet is. Sounds familiar, mind you.
There's a lot of blacks, though. Black Lagoon, Black Jack.
Action, drama, mystery, sci-fi, science fiction, seinen. There's a lot of tags there. Only 13 episodes. It's not too bad.
The art doesn't look too bad.
You want to read it?
Sure. In the year, and next year, actually.
2021.
Yeah, next year, mankind was defeated by Gastria, a parasitical virus, and is forced to live within a walls made of Varinium monoliths, a metal that is able to subdue Gastria. Soon, the cursed children born with the Gastria virus, who are able to control it. It's the same premise we get with all these virus ones, which gives them superhuman pout abilities.
Word discovered.
Yeah, I know. I was pausing because it was a pause there. Where discovered, due to the gastrovirus intervention, the cursed children could only be female. Oh, of course. Civil securities are formed to specialize in flight and against Gastra, operating with the pair of an initiator, who are cursed children, and a promoter serving to lead the cursed children. Ten years after the war, Rentaro Sadami, a high school student who was also a promoter, and his childhood friend Kisara Tendo's civil security. That's what it said.
And it is what it said.
Along with his initiator Inju Ahara, receives a secret mission to prevent the Tokyo area's destruction.
Probably not going to be great, but you never know.
Yeah, but I've noticed that every time we get one of these viruses, it's the same premise.
Yeah.
Why is it always the same premise? Like, that Power Ranger one was the same one, same premise.
Yeah, they sort of take it over.
The Virus Buster one. The last, I don't remember what it was, but I recall vividly, we just watched one not too long ago that was filled with viruses that had the same exact thing going on.
Maybe that's just something they like, I don't know.
What was the one with the monsters? Like, they were turning into monsters and stuff. Do you remember?
No.
Oh my god, it's driving me nuts now. It was...
You should watch Parasite the Maxim. It's a parasite, and a couple people can control the parasite.
Oh, yeah.
That's a good show, though. That's a really good.
Yeah, it was like the girl had psychic powers. Oh, my God. I can't remember for life. It was like in W or X or Y.
Sorry.
Yeah, it was...
Anyway.
It was one of them. I don't know. Doesn't matter.
Next episode, guys.
Black Bullet.
Black Bullet.
Bye.
See ya.